Have they arrived yet?
Just got here.
All right. Well, that's good. We better say something then.
Yep.
Well,
hi.
Hi.
Well,
hey,
welcome.
You stepped over my line.
You stepped on my line.
My line?
Yep.
Yep.
Just yep.
No.
You, yep.
You did.
I was supposed to say, hello.
Hello.
It's,
this is another episode of Bob and Bill. Actually, it's not.
No.
Officially.
No.
Because we took over the Mobro Show.
We sure did. This is a Mobro Show takeover.
Yep.
Bob and Bill edition.
Yep. And we commandeered it.
Sabotage.
Takeover.
Like an inside man.
We wrapped it up and threw it over our shoulder.
We jumped on the train. We robbed the conductor and we told him, get in the caboose.
We stole the handbasket.
We just walked down the street with so much style, everybody stopped and looked at us and said, hey, that must be their show.
Yeah, but we're making money by the town.
Money, money, money by the pound. Money, money, money by the pound.
Money, 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 money by the
pound. And Homeward Bound?
Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah, and Homeward Bound. Yep.
Yeah.
Yep. What, he swallowed a bug or something?
Yep.
What kind of bug?
It was a big bug.
I think if a big bug you swallowed, flu, it must have.
It had the flu? Oh, no!
Oh, my goodness. Where's my mask? Put a mask on. I don't know if that's going to help.
I got a survivor on it. This is a disease. Breaker, breaker.
What are you saying?
I have no idea.
Well,
so we would like to welcome you to our cabin.
Yeah, to our cabin right here.
It's deep in the woods. Who knows where? I don't even remember it half the time.
Yeah, but we somehow find it every single time. I think the address has something to do with L and a zero.
Oh.
And
yeah, something about a co-pilot.
Yep, maybe something. We'll figure it out.
Yep, one of these days.
We'll figure it out. So, on the show today,
yep.
Because we took the official Mobro Show camera.
We did.
And that's what's filming us right now.
It is.
And it's special.
Special.
It's not like they couldn't take any other camera and film their show and then try to post it at the same time.
Oh,
right?
No. It has to be this camera.
It has to be this.
So, heaven forbid, this camera gets lost, stolen, copied.
Stolen.
Broken into.
Stolen.
Hacked.
Stolen.
Then they won't have a show.
Yeah.
So, if anybody really does not like the Mobro Show, they could really do some damage by getting this camera, doing a little razzle-dazzle, throwing it out the window, maybe over the Bay Bridge, and then no more Mobro Show. Presto, change.
If they can throw it over the Bay Bridge, they should go into the NFL.
Actually, that's a good point.
Yeah.
They got quite an arm if they could throw it over the Bay Bridge.
And then they wouldn't need to actually sell this camera or throw it over the Bay Bridge to get money or anything. They just have this make money in the NFL.
That's true. I'm pretty sure we just brought down the wrath of Tom Brady on us.
Oh, no. Tom Brady.
Tom Brady.
And you should see, we cut a mouse, and then we kept it.
Brady Bunch.
Brady Bunch.
Oh.
Became the Brady Bunch. The Brady Bunch.
Oh, that just shaking my mind. Tom Brady Bunch?
Tom Brady Bunch.
What?
It's a bunch of Brady's. Of Tom Brady's.
That's a thought, you know, just a bunch of Brady's looking around.
Think about as many Tom Brady's as he's won, like Super Bowls.
The Brady Bunch.
Yeah.
That'd be a lot.
That is a lot. It's a lot of Super Bowls.
It's a lot of Tom Brady's.
Yeah.
So what are we going to do today, Bill?
Well, Bob, we have a special treat for these folks out here.
Have we got a show for you?
Oh, we do. We absolutely, definitely, positively do. Yeah. We absolutely, definitely, positively do. We do. Yeah. We absolutely, positively, absolutely, positively do.
In the back.
Yep. Yeah. Let's bounce. Land back. And make it, make it, make it, make it, make it, make it. and Wade and Tay.
Well, that was unnecessary, but quite fire.
Yep, that was absolutely firing on my head.
Uh-oh.
Thanks. Thanks. Is it gone?
Nope.
Well, then why didn't you...
So, that is quite some coordination you got there.
I got some coordination.
What coordination are you talking about?
Coordination for this quarantine that we've been having. I've been stuck with you.
You've been stuck with me your whole life.
Well, yeah. Ever since I got married to Dolores, you were there.
You got married?
You know that?
Was I in your wedding?
Yeah, you were the best man. That's what I mean.
I am the best man.
Okay. Yeah, ever since I got married to Dolores, you were there.
You got married to the car from Back to the Future?
That's the DeLorean.
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 He's married to a car.
Apparently, you think I'm married to a car.
You said it yourself.
I did not say it myself.
You said DeLorean.
It yourself that I said it myself.
I said it myself.
You said it yourself twice, and then I said it, but you said it, but you made me say it, so it's not true.
You kind of look like Doc Brown.
Oh, yeah, I am Doc Brown.
Whoa, that makes sense. See, I don't even have to talk about that because it makes sense. My point has been proven. Thank you very much.
I'm a time traveler.
Check the gate. Moving on.
Yep.
You're also the doctor?
Doc Brown. Doc Bill Brown.
Bill Brown.
Yeah, Doc Bill Brown is...
actually makes me think of something.
What?
Do we have last names? I don't think I've ever thought about that my whole life.
You know what? I don't know if we do.
I cannot for the life of me think of my last name.
If we did, I can't remember what our last name is.
That's a terrifying thought.
Yeah. No. I tell you, we are important enough to have last names.
I don't know. Bill, I just don't know.
We are important enough to have last names.
Are you sure?
I am absolutely sure.
I think about all the characters in history who don't have last names.
Well, what?
Stuff happens to them. They die. They get thrown overboard. They become poor beggars in the wilderness. They... get trampled by horses and pigs and goats and gazelles. They have octopi thrown. I told you. I don't have a last name. I told you.
Now wait, this octopi has nothing to do with our last name.
I told you. I told you, Bill. Bill, I told you. I don't have a last name.
You do have a last name.
Do I? For all you know, I'm just Bob.
Or crewman number 6.
Ooh.
What's my last name?
You have a last name.
Do I?
Well, anyway.
Now we digress. After that. This has been about... 10 minutes.
Oh boy. All right. We should probably tell them what's going on.
We should tell them what's going on. Ready? You know what's going on?
What's going on?
You know what's going on the show today?
What's going on in the show
we're
today?
We're going on the show today.
We're already on the show, Bill.
We are on the show.
They've been watching the show for darn near 2 hours now.
We've been on the show for 2 hours?
Yeah, it feels like it.
Really?
Yep.
Is that how long that the...
I'm getting hungry.
Well. Oh. Well, I just... ate a whole pig.
Wow. That's impressive.
Yep.
So, we got a little sneaky surprise.
Yep.
So here's the thing.
We didn't just commandeer the show.
Mm-mm. So we have been keeping tabs on the Mobro Show for some time now.
Yes, we have.
And along with the Mobro Show, which has been awesome and cool and fun to watch.
Yeah, it's all right.
We've noticed some things that the Mo Bros maybe haven't shown you.
Yeah. Like, yeah, there are some... You know, there's this thing called editing.
That's real. I thought it was a conspiracy.
Yep, there's this thing called editing.
Editing. Thomas Edison.
Thomas Edison. Thomas Edison is the originator of editing.
He literally originated the lightning bolt.
But then he invented editing.
He invented editing.
Yep.
Invented editing.
Invented editing.
He invented editing.
And he went and edited it.
That makes me think of motorcycles in the desert, which makes me think of Scorpion King, which makes me think of that one band that did that one song.
What?
Exactly. Boom. So tell him.
So I have also commandeered a tape.
A tape of what?
A tape of bloopers.
You got blueprints?
I got.
Is it the blueprints?
I got some bloopers.
Blueprints?
I got some
Some blueprints of the vault?
Well, I got those
blueprints of our cabin?
I got the blueprints of the vault and of our cabin.
Blueprints.
But I'm not going to tell you what I'm going to do with those yet, okay. Because I don't even know what I'm going to do with those yet. But I got blueprints for the vault. I got blueprints for the cabin. I've got blueprints for the skateboard park. I've got blueprints for that high-rise building that they did their show on.
Wow. That's why I started to move.
What?
Somebody must have stolen the blueprints.
What started to move?
The buildings. The city.
The city started moving?
Yeah.
Oh! The city did start to move.
Uh-huh.
Yep. Because they called someone and made it move.
That's right. So the bloopers.
The bloopers.
Bloopers.
No, blue purse.
Blue prince.
Blue purse.
Blue king.
Blue king?
Yeah, because it's a blue prince. He just graduated to king. I think he was the king of Eiffel 65.
Oh, I get it. Yep. That Eiffel... I always think of a radio tower when I think of Eiffel 65.
Oh, you think of Paris.
That's true.
You think that's a radio tower?
I do. I think that's one gigantic radio tower.
Who knew France gets the best radio reception?
And that's it. That's all it is the best radio reception anywhere.
Yeah. We can play some tunes on that one.
Yep, I bet we can remotely attach ourselves to the remote.
What?
I bet we could actually remotely attach ourselves to that radio tower in Paris and we could broadcast our voices across the whole city.
Brilliant. Then we'd get the Mobro show going worldwide.
Could you imagine in Paris, the whole of Paris, you hear Bob and Bill.
Bob and Bill.
Bob and Bill.
I like it. I think we should do it. Anyway, that's a story for another time that we're going to do.
Yep.
Now, we got a little special surprise for you.
Yeah.
So you're talking about the bloopers.
The bloopers.
Bloopers.
Yeah, I've got some bloopers.
Bloopers.
From the Mobro Show episode.
Uh-oh.
And they don't know I have this.
Uh-oh.
But we're going to show you all the outtakes, all the sections that were cut.
So
because they did some editing.
The word.
What?
Mum's the word.
Mum's the word here.
Mm-hmm.
So just remember that you didn't see this from us.
Nope. We ain't really here.
Nope.
We're just mirages.
Yep. We're margarines.
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 We're just margarine.
Margin to the sunset.
We are margins from outer space.
Really?
Hey, that makes me think of that one movie we were in.
What movie?
The one, was it produced by Scott Rogers? Is that the guy?
Yeah!
He called us up and he was like, Hey! You want to do this film?
Yep.
We were like, Yep. We didn't ask any questions about it. We just did it.
Yeah, we just did it. And it was Star Wars Day.
That's right.
Star Wars Day indeed.
Yep.
And then a Vader baby showed up.
Oh, that was scary. We had to get out of there.
Yep, and I was not expecting that.
Nope.
See, when you go onto a film set, you usually should expect certain things.
Right.
I did not expect that. I know it's Star Wars Day, but that was scary.
Yep.
All right? And when there's something that scary, I run like a little child.
Yep. I may or may not have peed my pants.
That's disgusting.
You're disgusting.
I'm disgusting. You're the one who said that you went wee-wee in your pants.
Yeah, I went wee-wee-wee all the way home.
Okay, well, I just pulled some hair off my mustache.
That's painful.
Yeah, it is, but I didn't feel nothing.
Because you got nerve damage.
Where do you think I got nerve damage from?
Because you fell off of Sears Tower.
I did.
Yep. So, you think we should roll the blooper tape?
I think we should. I think we should roll the blooper tape.
Our goal.
But I just got to work in the code here.
Oh. You know how to work that? Bill, you're pretty high tech.
I am absolutely high tech.
Look at him. Look at him go. Look at the keyboard.
When I was a youngin', I was a hacker. Hacker.
Seriously?
Yeah.
Why does that not surprise me? Are you quite finished?
You know, this part takes the longest.
His typing just went beyond 100%. The fervor with which he is typing right now is causing a 5.5 on the Richter scale. I smell smoke.
Where?
Right there.
Right. Oh my goodness, this is smoke.
Oh, yep. Now, Jacket's on fire now. Bill, you're on fire.
Wait, what?
You want me to call the fire department?
No.
You're on fire.
I'm on fire. What?
All right, so here. You forget.
No.
Okay. I think I know the button to press. I'll press the that is not what I was expecting. This ain't 20,000 leagues under the sea. Oh, we're just throwing all kinds of sea life at me now. Okay, now we got Pokemon. All right, I'm going to hit the button. You guys enjoy this. I'm going to fight a war against this guy.
Is that copyrighted?
Nope.
So, we have...
I'd say some of...
Acts 23.
Great passage, great scripture.
Yeah, okay. All right. Well, back onto the Acts. All right, back to the Acts of the Quarantine Showcase. We have... Well, we need to comment on them. All right, well, here we...
Nope. I don't like that.
So, nope. Okay, here we go. All right, that was so much fun. They did such a good job with that. And the fact that it's the whole... All right, that was fantastic. Nope. Okay. All right, I'm going to overthink it. All right.
Just go.
So that was a ton of fun. That
it was great. Fun.
Yeah.
It was fun.
The fact that so many of their family... I'm not even going to say... Okay. Our next, not contestant, our next...
Talent,
yeah, okay.
Our next
our
talent.
Next submitter.
Submitter, yes. Okay. So, speaking of Ireland, our next talent is relevant. That's dumb.
He is relevant.
Our next...
So, speaking of Ireland, our next talent is related. Nope.
He's related to Ireland.
Yeah. Okay, all right, here we go. I'm just going to roll it. So, speaking of Ireland.
It is to the song, She Is Love by the Parachutes.
She Is Love by Parachute.
Oh. What did I say?
It is to the song.
Oh,
yeah.
Especially the community theater.
Yep.
To the community theater theme. Okay. Yeah. So, all right. What do we have next? Ask me anything.
So, what do we have next?
So, we have next, up next, is...
And Roland.
Which is...
It's John King.
Caleb Heidel and
Kirby. Caleb Heidel and Kirby.
I think that'd be really funny to just be like, it's John King, Caleb Heidel, and Kirby.
Kirby. All
right.
Okay. One word. Like Madonna.
Like Madonna.
It's Roland.
Okay.
Cool.
John King, Caleb Heidel, and Kirby do a live stream on Friday nights singing different songs. They do COVID-19 Instagram live streams every Friday night. And we're doing the Beatles. Okay, so they do different things.
Yeah.
So this trio, they do live streams on Friday nights.
Yep.
On the Instagram that was posted.
That one.
I don't remember how I'm going to edit this together. Okay, this trio... Blah, blah, blah. This trio... This trio does... Why is this so hard? Okay.
It's all right.
This trio does... Oh my gosh! Ooh! Bohemian Rhapsody!
Diapada. Wait, to do that again. It's...
Was Queen the 80s?
Yeah.
I figured, but...
We are.
Thank you, John King. Thank you, Caleb Heidel. Thank you, Kirby.
You want to try it again?
Thank you, John King. Thank you, Caleb Heidel. And thank you, Kirby. The first
chapeau?
The first chapeau.
The second.
Ah, the annual. Second.
Oh, I see what you're doing.
Hold on, okay, anyway. All right, so.
Okay.
All right. You know I'm going to pull something from YouTube. But
yes, I know. I heard it in my head, like...
Yeah.
Like, over top of what we were talking about.
I don't even know where to find the Twilight Zone theme, but... And...
That was good. Resisting laughing at himself.
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah.
And I loved it. I loved it.
Okay. So...
Transitioning.
Next. Okay.
Okay. By the way, the song, the first, by the way, the first song, what song did she do?
Yeah, I don't actually know the name of that song.
Can't Help Falling in Love by Elvis.
That was Can't Help Falling in Love?
Right?
No.
I would have known that
I song. I can't help.
Wait, what did she do?
Falling in love.
Make You Feel My Love. It was made popular by Adele, but it was written by...
Make You Feel My Love.
Make You Feel My Love.
Make You Feel My Love.
Make You Feel My Love. Okay.
Yes.
Okay, written by Bob Dylan, released by Billy Joel.
Ah.
And then Adele recently made it popular.
Bob Dylan, Billy Joel, and... Okay, wow. Bob Dylan, Billy Joel, blah, blah, blah. And she is doing the song... She's doing the song. She is performing the song, Make You Fall in Love With Me.
Make You Feel My Love.
Make You... Make you, make you, yeah, right, okay.
Oh, love stuff.
Make You Feel My Love, okay. And she is performing the song Make You Feel My Love, written by Bob Dylan, made popular by... No, performed by...
Yeah, written by Bob Dylan for Billy Joel.
For Billy Joel, okay.
Yep.
All right.
And then Adele made it popular recently.
Okay. John King.
And then...
John King, yeah.
And Caleb Heidel and Kirby.
Yep.
Yeah.
Tell me what the mantis action is. What is that?
Mantis action is one when he goes out on a journey to find himself.
That's called the manticing.
Mantis.
Oh, the mantis.
Could be also the womantis.
You know, I just thought this would be the perfect show for the Wiggles to join.
Imbeciles.
Well...
Ladies and gentlemen, the amazing, spectacular, farting hedgehog.
This is just Sonic the Hedgehog music.
There you go. Because everybody knows that this is Sonic the Hedgehog.
Who's had one too many chili dogs.
Who's had one too many chili dogs. And there was, I think, there was a movie, or there was historical documents of the hedgehog on Earth, Sonic the Hedgehog, and they made a movie off of these historical documents. But boy, for whatever reason, they thought that Sonic looked like this. And it looked... But this is what it actually looks like. The Hedgehog, Sonic the Hedgehog, what he actually looks like, which is the accurate look for the historical documents.
Are you talking about Richard Simmons with blue leg hair?
Yes! That's what everyone thought that Sonic looked like, was Richard Simmons in a blue furry onesie. That's not what Sonic looks like. Sonic looks like this. I know this is what a hedgehog looks like. But that's not what Sonic looks like. All right. Anyway. Put your coffee down. I'm off my soapbox.
We should eventually get to the point where we give out prizes to people.
Yes.
Like a t-shirt or something.
If they we can should guess do
the,
that.
The references.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Eventually leading to a cash prize.
Cash money.
Woohoo!
Cash money.
Money.
I can buy more comics.
Okay. I don't know what that was.
You know what that also made me think of? Cash! I spend every dollar of it! Anyway.
Yeah, I was getting into it. That was good.
Oh, yeah, that was really
good. And my money's gone in a flash!
Yeah.
They'll take every dollar of it!
Yep. Whoever the vague they is.
They. Everyone has a they. Everyone has a they that their money goes to. It
yeah.
could be anything. That's that they. That they took my money. They spent my money. They have my money.
That darn they.
They.
Mm. So, all right.
We are on fire tonight. Okay.
Fire!
All right.
That sounded like a cat.
Yeah.
That was weird. Saying fire. You know, like cats sometimes, they meow and say a word.
Fire!
Yeah. See, that's where the Lion Luna thing clip should go.
Yeah.
Okay.
Anyway.
You should just put the 2 seconds for right.
Yeah,
yeah, right.
You totally should do that.
Yeah. Do you know cats make funny noises?
Yep.
Yep. I don't know how we got on the cat segment, but...
Did you know cats are grumpy?
Cats are grumpy. Hey. Shameless plug.
Grumpy. Cats are grumpy. Cats are grumpy.
Shameless plug. If you want to check out... No, it's not even out yet. Shameless plug. We have a preview on our YouTube page.
Yep.
For the music video, Cats Are Grumpy, which is a collaboration of The Mobro Show and Triple L. We worked with them on a song called Cats Are Grumpy.
It's pretty cool.
Because we wanted to show everyone and tell everyone that cats are grumpy.
It's true. If you really think about it, it's true.
Yes. And that music video will be coming out soon.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. But there's a preview on our YouTube page. Cats Are Grumpy.
She's in the USC and she hasn't tapped in 20 years.
Yeah. You've got me going now. Right. Okay.
Fun fact about that, I learned how to drive manual in England.
Wow.
That was a really fun experience.
I think I forgot about that.
Yeah. So technically, my dad taught me here and kind of showed me the ropes and in a scout in
the National Park. Where are the ropes?
Here's some ropes.
Yep. You showed them to me.
Show them the ropes.
Ropes.
Oh, this is a cord. Never mind.
And
here, show them the ropes.
That's also a cord.
That is a cord.
Show them the ropes.
That is definitely
tape. That's tape. Show them the ropes.
This is great, except it's yarn.
Oh, dang it.
Okay, never mind.
So, and then I flew over to England on a tour with Aaron Long and Chris Bernstorff and proceeded to learn the rest of real life training, trial by fire, driving a stick shift, not only on the wrong side of the car, but the wrong side of the road. That's a story for another time.
Wow.
Anyway, if you are a fan of heavier music, you can check out that band. If you're not a fan of heavier music, you can download the music, give it to a gift as a prank. Give it to a gift? No, let me try it again. If you are a fan of that type of music, let me try it again. If you are a fan of heavier music, you can check out the band. If you are not a fan of heavier music, you can download the album and you can give it to a friend as a gift. Nope, let me try it again. If you are a fan of heavy music, you can check out the album. If you are not a fan of heavy music, you can download the album and nope. So, this is a guitar cover, which, dang, I don't even know what the song is. So we have here a sampling of his guitar skills for you to enjoy.
What was I saying? Unless they want to pay the money to actually have the song in there. I think that's how the rules work. I do believe that song is copyrighted.
It was a really touching documentary about the refreshment choices of that band. You know,
yeah.
Beatles juice.
The Beatles juice, yes. It wasn't Beatles water.
Mm-mm. It wasn't Beatles soda.
It wasn't Beatles soda. It
wasn't Beatles beer.
Yeah, it wasn't even...
Beatles of Bubbles.
Yep.
Well...
And Merry Christmas.
Wowee! You got the fire put out.
Did I miss the show?
Maybe.
Did it start yet?
Yes, it started... like... 2 hours ago.
It's been that long?
Yep.
Have you been sitting here talking to these people for 2 hours? Do you realize that the Mo Bros have been trying to make their show an hour or less? So if you're talking to them for 2 hours, then everyone's going to be like, what?
Listen, I was just sleeping here.
They were watching you sleeping for 2 hours?
That's terrifying. You all were watching me sleep?
How dare you watch him sleep for two hours?
That's creepy.
How dare you sleep for 2 hours?
That's creepy. Wait a minute. I need my sleep. I don't look up and wake in the morning like this without my beauty sleep.
Yeah, I'll leave my comments out of that one. No comment. No comment. But I do have this. It's the anti-put-yourself-on-fire gem.
Oh my gosh, where'd you find it?
I found it back there.
Back where?
Back there.
In the yard?
Yep, in the yard. I just dug a hole, found it. Because when you're on fire, you know, you dig a hole. That's everybody
naturally
knows that. This stop, drop, and roll stuff, that, you know, you gotta dig a hole and find one of these. And then it puts the fire right out.
So you're saying instead of stop, drop, and roll, it's stop, drop, and hole?
Yep. Absolutely.
That sounds like a good idea.
Yep. And then you go mining for these things like the dwarves.
So what you're saying is that we have built our house, our cabin...
That's disgusting.
Excuse me. We have built our cabin on a bed of rocks, quarantine quartz that lets us stop fire retardants. Yeah, by retardant that makes us stop fire in its tracks. We can make millions.
We can make millions.
We just gotta dig holes.
We just dig holes.
You wanna run away? Go ahead, start running. I won't stop you.
And make millions by digging holes. This is a brand new idea.
Yes, it is. We don't even need to commandeer this show anymore.
This, yep, we don't have to do
that. We got a maid. We got a maid. We're sitting on gold.
We're sitting on gold.
Yeah.
That reminds me of the 49ers.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, we got that from them.
That was they got that from us.
Oh, they did?
Yeah, we were the 49ers.
That's true.
Where were you in 49?
Well, I was being a hacker.
Bill.
What?
Didn't have dang computers back in 59, 49, whatever year it was.
Well, they have these things. That's a computer. That's computing. Radio waves.
Our
from
Lord,
one side to the
help
next.
Me. Bill does not know what he has done.
What have I done?
I know. You tell me.
I've been a hacker.
Yeah. What did you hack? That one ain't nothing to hack in 49.
You know what?
The only thing you'll be hacking was the dirt to get the gold.
Yes, I was.
Hack. 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 You didn't know it was back in those days of old. It was made in 49, but nobody really paid time to check it out, check it out. We started eBay, Bob and Bill.
Yep, that's not true at all. I didn't hear a word you said.
You were just too busy hacking.
I was hacking. I was called a hamster hacker.
The only hacking, really, that you do is when you get cold.
Yep. I was called a hamster hacker.
Hacking. My goodness.
Hamster hacker. That's a specific kind of hacker that does little tiny hacking jobs like a hamster would in one of those rolly ball things.
Dolores, are you going to fix this? Are you going to fix this, Dolores?
She's not paying attention to you.
I'm on my own, folks.
Ah!
I'm on my own. I'm wanted. Dead or alive. That was pretty good. I didn't know you recorded that.
I did. I recorded that whole guitar part.
Wow.
Right, Dolores?
She's ignoring you, too.
She's ignoring me, too.
Hey, you know what guitar solo I wrote and did?
What?
And performed?
Which one?
Check it out. Oh, yeah.
Hmm.
I love that one.
Yeah. So good.
Yep.
So brilliant.
Yep.
Speaking of brilliance.
Yep.
There is a friend of the Mo Bros.
Okay.
A longtime friend of the Mo Bros.
Us?
Besides us.
Oh, you know, right,
we're the best belonging friends of the Mo Bros. But there is a friend... Long friend of the Mo Bros, and he got married.
Really?
He got married.
Congratulations.
Congratulations. He got married about 9 years ago.
Whoa. Wow.
Yeah.
That's a long time.
That is a long time.
9 years?
9 years.
Wow.
What were we doing 9 years ago?
Apparently you were a hacker.
Yep. Because that was just 9 years ago.
We grow old very quickly.
But apparently.
Yeah.
Apparently like that Benjamin Button fellow.
Yeah, that's kind of confusing because he's like kind of aging backwards too.
Yep.
That's just a whole other story.
That's a different thing.
Yeah.
But this friend, his name is Fletcher Abbott.
Oh, the man.
Yeah.
He's awesome.
And he's been a longtime friend of the Mo Bros.
Yep.
And he got married about 9 years ago.
Wow.
He and his wife, Emily.
Yep.
And we just wanted to also show all of you a video that the Mo Bros did in honor of Fletcher getting married.
Wow.
And here it is.
Hi, Fletcher. It's us two.
Hey, Fletcher.
And we got our karaoke machine out and found a song that you might enjoy.
And it applies to you.
And I thought it would fit the occasion. And so you need to picture this song playing in your head on Friday.
No, it's not by Rebecca Black.
No, it's not that song.
It's different.
It's different. Press play.
There's just a few more hours, that's all the time you've got. A few more hours before they tie the knot. I'm getting married in the morning. Ding dong, the bells are gonna chime. Pull out the stopper, let's have a whopper, but get me to the church on time. I got to be there in the morning.
Yes, we do.
3 o'clock, a drink within me prime. Girls, come and kiss me, show how you'll miss me, but get me to the church on time. If I am dancing, roll up the floor. If I am whistling, be out the door. For I'm getting married in the morning. Ding dong, the bells are gonna chime. Drink up for office, but don't lose the compass. And get me to the church, get me to the church. Be sure and get me to the church on time. Stand me and nail me, but get me to the church on time. I got to be there in the morning, spruced up and looking in me prime. Some bloke who's able, lift up the table, but get me to the church on time. If I am flying, then shoot me down. If I am wooing, get him out of town. Oh, I'm getting married in the morning. Ding dong, the bells are gonna chime. Feather and Tommy, call out the army and get me to the church. Get me to the church. Make sure and get me to the church.
Talking about you.
That's you. Yeah, now I believe that they recorded that before his wedding.
Okay. Yeah, oh, true. True. It was kind of leading up to it.
Yeah. And you probably wonder why we even brought this up. Well, it's because a day ago was...
It was actually on Thursday.
What?
It was actually on Thursday.
About Thursday?
Yep.
What?
It was on Thursday.
It was on Thursday?
It was on Thursday.
It was on, what?
It was on Thursday.
It was on Thursday.
It was on Thursday.
But today's Monday.
Right. So it was on Thursday.
Their anniversary was on Thursday?
It was on Thursday.
It was on Thursday?
Last Thursday.
You're confusing me.
So today's Monday.
Yeah.
Yesterday was Sunday.
Yeah.
The day before that was Saturday.
Yeah.
The day before that, I'm pretty sure it was Friday.
I'm pretty sure.
And what was the day before that?
Well, I think it should be Thursday.
Exactly.
I still don't understand, but that's just because I probably don't understand.
You're a hacker.
You should understand everything.
Apparently I should.
Hack into the system.
Yeah.
Why don't you?
All right.
Siri. Ask Google. Ask Alexa. Ask Cortana. And he's hacking. You know, that reminds me of the Muppets. You know what also reminds me of the Muppets?
What?
Us. No!
I forget what I was hacking.
Wow. Wow. Some hacker you are in the middle of hacking, you forget what you're hacking.
I better stop before it starts smoking again.
Yes, please. I don't want to have to fight the war against Oceana anymore.
Oceana and Pokemon.
Osha Pokemona.
Osha Pokemona, and we have got this.
Yeah. You know, it also made me think of, when you said 9 years.
Yep.
It made me think, well, happy anniversary, by the way.
Happy anniversary.
It was their anniversary this last week, so we wanted to honor them.
Yep.
And the Mo Bros wanted to as well.
Yep.
The 9 years makes me think of... It's been a while since I've tried to sing. Roll the nine fingers and the ring of doom.
Frodo of the nine fingers and the ring of doom.
Where'd you learn to sing like that?
Tom Bombadil taught me.
You met Tom Bombadil?
Yes, sir.
Wait. Where can I meet him?
So, you know how he was not featured in the movies?
Yeah.
We were off in Australia hacking, getting to know each other.
You were hiking while I was hacking.
Exactly. You're a hacker. I'm a hiker.
Okay. So you were hiking what trail?
The Tom Bombadil trail.
The Tom Bombadil trail.
With Tom Bombadil.
While they were filming, and that's why you are solely responsible for Tom Bombadil not being in those films.
Wow, I just dug myself a very deep grave.
You know, people, I just want to apologize for my brother Bob, because he kept everyone from being able to see Tom Bombadil in the films because he was joy hiking up some trail that I've never heard of, and he didn't take me with him.
Fair. Very fair. I don't have much to go to come back from that with, so I think that it is probably about time to try to wrap up the show. Otherwise, my brother is going to give me the cold shoulder. Or the people's elbow.
Here's the shoulder. Here's the elbow.
Uh-oh. All right. At least that's all that he's doing. I'm okay with that. He turned his head. Okay. So now that my brother's completely ignoring me, so we would like to thank you all for watching the Mo Bro Show in general. This is a special episode that we are honored to be able to be a part of.
Honored.
I really enjoyed last week, especially that was the Western one.
I absolutely enjoyed that one because of the mustaches.
Yeah, all the mustaches. That's where it's at.
Yep.
You know who else has a good mustache, though?
Who?
This guy. Yep, that's a good one.
Yep.
A lot of men aspire to have that kind of mustache.
Yep.
It's a good one.
Yep.
So, you know, another one that's kind of well sought after is Hulk Hogan.
And look at the flash balls.
He has a good one. Sometimes that kind of looks kind of fake.
Yep.
Dolores wants your attention.
Can you catch a shark?
Bring it here. I'm going to catch a shark.
What is it with this wildlife in the ocean?
This is called virtual wildlife.
Sharks terrify me. He's hacking again. What's he doing? Uh-oh.
Did it bite?
He missed the fish.
Okay, you gotta turn his volume up completely, because I can't hear a thing.
I don't think the volume is gonna help with that.
There was barely any type of vibration. It bit, and then I pressed A.
but then it was felt like another bite and nibble. So what? I didn't get it.
Bill. Bob, whatever your name is.
Nah. See, your own wife can't keep our name straight.
You know, I'm trying to work on that.
Y'all should wear name tags.
I remember my name.
I do too, sometimes. And then we're with Pete.
That's right.
And Tom.
Pete and Tom, not to be confused with Tom Bombadil.
Yep. Then it's even harder to remember what my name is.
That's true.
Especially when Joe rides out.
That's true. Joe is there and Uncle Bobby.
I forgot about Uncle Bobby.
Yeah, that gets real confusing because we got the same name.
Forget about Uncle Bobby.
I try to erase that from my memory.
Yeah.
Me too.
Yeah, we don't talk much about Uncle Bobby.
Uncle Bobby's, he's something.
He's something, all right.
He's really something.
Well, was there anything else?
Other than the fact that you didn't take me on your hike with Tom Bombadil.
Okay, let's just make me keep reliving that over and over and over again and never let me live that down. That sounds like a good idea.
Thank you for watching the show.
There was so much sarcasm in that.
Thank you, everyone, for watching the show and for enjoying it and for laughing at it and laughing at him.
Me? What? Wow. Wow. Wow.
Oh, we got another fish.
Is there another shark? I'm going to get this one.
Okay. Turn the volume up.
Here, turn it way up. He just caught a sucker fish.
That's it. I'm out of here.
Well, folks, that couldn't have ended on a better note for me. I'd like to thank you on behalf of Bob and Bill, right here from our cabin, with the stolen Mobro camera, access to the vault from the hacker's position right here, and the hiker right here, having done the recon mission to gather all the bloopers together to show you fine gentlemen, ladies. You all are fantastic. We love you a lot. The Mobros love you a lot. I think that's it. So, on that note, wait.
Oh
my gosh. On that note, we'll see you later. Oh, man, my back.